So, first game, boys, first game. This is ROTS2, a Sultans battle, and these are the week one games. So, today it's Blitz versus Ash, and on Saturday we have Dragonstar versus, I think, Cynical, no, Tenacity, and we still have one more game.
Yeah, dragons are
So,
cynical link versus top spin.
yeah, Cynical link versus top spin. So what is this map, man? Mega random? Oh, this looks like Nomad. Oh shit.
It's launched for you. It's still not responding here.
For you?
Yeah, the game, it'll open in a while, I think.
Oh, I see.
Not a problem. So it looked like Nomad, but usually it's Land Nomad. Yeah, but then it had lesser food resources than normal.
See, but man,
This
this
game
is
fucked
crazy.
up.
I did not expect a Nomad on.
Exactly, same.
It's
I've
just crazy,
not
like.
played Nomad in a long time. Long, long time.
So you start
Here
with
we go.
three villages and then, or I think it's four villages, right? Or three.
No, three villages.
So now we already see both the
So.
players are going for the lumber camp because you need that wood to drop the TC. So
What time are you on?
I'm at 2 minutes 30 seconds, so I'll just pause the
Cool,
game.
same.
Say okay,
No,
perfect.
no, play it. Yeah, I'm at the same point.
So both the players are at one lumber camp. So and they are still looking for a nice location to drop their TCs and also gathering that wood to drop the TC. And what do you
So in
think of
a regular
this?
land nomad,
Yeah,
in a
go ahead.
regular land nomad, you just make a lumber camp, get 275 wood, and then make a TC. So in those maps, you usually have lots of deer and boar. This one was different from land nomad maps because you, I mean, if you look at the map without a fog of war, you'll find no boar or deer. There's only one boar for each player,
Oh, yes.
and one deer for some reason, yeah.
Oh, that's the perfect thing, right?
What?
That's perfect thing, right? Like both the players having only one deer and one boar.
Okay, yeah, but then it's a slower battle then. If both players have good food resources, they'll advance to feudal faster, fight faster and stuff.
I think that's the reason why it's called Mega Random.
Yeah, exactly.
Not to
Plus,
be.
you can see relics in the corners of the maps.
Yes, relics are. But there are a lot of relics. There are around eight relics.
Yeah, exactly. There are more than five. There are around 10. I think some 9 or 10 relic.
Oh, yeah,
10.
10 relics. That's just crazy. But we can already see
Plus,
Ash is.
all big wood patches are towards the outside.
So you have to
Nothing
go
in the
out
centers.
to get the wood. Yes. But I see you are going for the TC for the first. Maybe your
Yeah,
TC
both
will
of
be
us are.
first. Yeah. Both the players, but I think for a start point in the Blitz has got really good position for the TC
Wood.
wood, yeah,
Yeah, he
especially wood.
has.
And you are focusing more on food and gold.
I thought that this is a central location.
I see. So
Because for me, if you check the big woods outside, there is no gold or any food resource
yes,
there.
yeah, that's true.
So I had to come towards the center.
And also, I think that gives you sort of map control in the middle.
Yeah, plus my TC is up faster because I'm Celts, so I gather wood faster. So that is why I got 275 wood faster than him.
Oh, makes sense. Perfect.
So my advantage was still this point. Now he'll pull ahead in economy because of sheep.
Yeah, a
He's
lot of
Britons.
sheep.
And this map, there are lots of sheep, lots and lots of sheep. So that
And
Briton bonus is going to kick in soon.
they gather faster. But so far, I mean, the stat-wise, it's pretty much similar for both the players, except with the food advantage for Blitz because he has a ton of sheep and also that
Yeah,
boost
wood and
bonuses.
food.
So, man, that's pretty interesting stat. And
Yeah, so this part was pretty boring. You can look at the fog of war for each player. We're just exploring with sheep, lots of
yeah.
sheep. I remember having numbered around 7 or 8 sheep and then just randomly moving them everywhere.
With the exploration stuff, yeah, both the players have equally explored the map, and Blitz knows where you are, and also you almost know him.
I don't know about his TC, but I know about his lumber camp.
So that's like pretty much giving you the direction where he might be in. And this map, and whenever I get some maps like this, I go just crazy and just take all my villages and try to do all stupid stuff and fail and lose.
No, main thing is to stay calm, which I don't. That's what you should do.
So far, yeah, pretty cool and normal start. No one is being aggressive. Yep. No one is trying to kill each other with villagers.
Yeah, exactly. No point in that. You'll run into the TC.
Yeah, and which you especially see in these mega random open maps, like players try to kill each other and die in Dark Age itself.
True.
So we can expect like some sort of proper game here.
We can expect some fun games from Mega Random. Yep.
That's the whole point of this Mega Random map. So
exactly,
you don't know what seed you might be getting, and like what sort of map, and different resource locations and stuff. Especially,
I was happy it was Land Nomad and not the regular one. I have no idea how to play that.
Lucky you.
I'm not used to water at all, so I get confused.
Looking at the will difference between both the players, not pretty big. Both the players are at 14 wills, as and Blitz.
Yep. But he'll, I think he'll stockpile more food than me.
Yeah.
I'm only getting food from berries and sheep, and he's getting the faster sheep.
Yeah.
He is also luring his boar now.
Boar now, yeah. You already almost have finished it.
So this game had around 450 to 500 ping throughout.
Shit. Is it true?
So yeah.
Is it true? Like so that's 600 ping?
Yeah, so sometimes it was yellow, sometimes it was normal.
I see.
So that's why you will see an early loom sometimes from both of us.
Hey, Mystigan. Hello, Rohan. Everyone, welcome to welcome to the stream.
Oh.
Hey, Mystigan, I just started streaming, dude. So this is live for now. And I'm streaming ROTS2 Sultans Battle. So right now we have Ask Ikara here and Blitz playing. They already played, I'm just streaming the game. And Ass is here as a co-caster.
And one problem in these maps is that we forget to make mills. Without mills, you can't make a farm.
Yes.
At this point, I realized I was running out of sheep.
I was thinking, why the hell you're not making any farms? And yeah, there you go, the mill is up.
And there was no berries, normal berries, because my TC was on the berries, so I made a mill there itself.
So, will-wise, you are Ass is ahead of one will already, and Blitz is still at 20. But will-wise, man, it looks like they already started walling off. And that midline, whatever the map
is
called.
I'm a baller.
So we see two houses from Ass and one house here from Indus. So they are like sort of marking their territory. Okay, don't come over this area. Let's see how
so yeah, going. As I said, Indus would have, my Blitz would have received more food from those sheep, so he advanced faster.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes.
It was hard to stockpile 500 every time.
Mm-hmm.
But eventually I got there. That's the benefit with kelts. You don't have to put villagers on wood. You can manage with less villagers on wood, so you add more to food and you can click up faster.
Yep.
That way.
So you still don't know where Blitz is, but Blitz can see.
Yeah, but I have an idea of his lumber camp, so I'll try and attack that first, something like that.
So we have the barracks coming out from you, and
plus I know his TC. I think if you look at the boar patch there. I didn't notice it at that time, but still.
So the barracks is up for both the players. And we have in Blitz going on stone. That's like sort of being some aggressiveness, I think. So if you see.
Plus towers are very useful for these land nomad because your TC is on wood and on some other resource. So if you tower that wood, usually people don't have lumber camps nearby.
Oh
Their
yeah.
first lumber camp is their TC itself.
Especially when those tours
So,
come up on those all the lumber camps and the main goal
हाँ
locations, it will
exactly.
be yeah, very
So,
difficult.
अच्छा ये I can't flare in this spectator mode.
You can't?
No, if you press the flare thing, it goes into fog of war.
No, you can remove it.
Huh?
You can remove fog of war.
No, I wanted to flare you the position where a tower would have been useful, like that.
Ah, like that. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so right now you can see I killed a villager there on a stone.
And your militia are already out, and I mean,
And mine
that's a
are
lot of
almost dead.
idle time.
It is, but he was planning to get them forward anyway, so it's not that big a deal.
But I still think that tower could have been on the gold instead of right next to
On the
this.
wood or gold, yeah. He's trying to play it safe, not get it denied. So
This
one difference between regular maps and this mega random or any land nomad in general is that you build your TC here, right? So if you look at the stone, if you go to my perspective and see stone, I only have 100 stone now.
Yes, true. Yes, just
And
100.
by default, we are all used to 200 stone. So you know the first counter tower that people drop, you can't do that without going on stone.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
You
so that was one
need
difficulty
that
I faced. I was
stone.
planning to counter tower this, but I
Hey,
didn't
don't.
have stone.
And also, your stone is. Yeah, it's pretty far
Yeah,
from
so
your TC.
then plus now if you look at the bottom, he is sneaking three archers into my base.
Yes. So, yeah, but there you go. You have skirms coming out soon. But
I do,
archers.
yeah.
That's perfect counter. And also, you have two archery ranges, and he has only one. He is on two archery ranges too, but
हाँ
some.
ब्रिटन्स ना
And also, they.
ब्रिटन आर्चर सुपर
Yeah.
पावरफुल
Super powerful, and
नॉट
also.
इन दिस एज आई थिंक
They have. I mean, like, from castle onwards, they become
हाँ फ्रॉम
powerful.
कासल ऑनवर्ड्स देयर कम स्नाइपर्स अभी
But
डू दे
still,
हैव एनी बूमर्स देखो
that tower is just a nuisance, and it's good for nothing.
हाँ बट दैट गिव्स हिम मैप कंट्रोल सो ही कैन ड्रॉप वन मोर टावर आउटसाइड ऑन माय आर्चरी रेंजेस एंड आई वोंट बी एबल टू डिनाई इट
But let's see what
बिकॉज़
happens.
वन टावर या दैट्स हाउ टावर रशेस वर्क यू मेक अ फर्स्ट सेफ टावर एंड देन यू स्टार्ट टावरिंग एसेंशियल एरियाज अराउंड दैट टावर
So both the players are housed now, as usual.
या
So there you go. The second tower is coming from Blitz. Let's see if that tower is gonna go
या
up or down.
Exactly. So similar villager numbers and all, army numbers as
And also
well. So
with like proper range, these towers are gonna be like
yeah, they're going to
nuisance.
be very painful for me. That's why I had to get this counter tower up, which I am trying to right now.
That tower, I think it makes perfect sense because you need
Because
that gold.
otherwise, it'll take my gold and my wood near the TC. So in general, I can't give him that much map control.
Yes.
That was essential. And the focus should also have been to break my tower, but auto fire. So units and buildings auto fire the highest HP thing or the most nearby thing.
Oh, is it
So
so?
in this case, yeah. So he'll shoot my barracks for a long time here.
Oh, this thing
Just
I
look at
didn't
the tower
know.
war.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that is why rams are so useful in archer wars.
Oh, I see.
All archers automatically target rams because they have the highest HP. So then your units can kill his.
So there you go, guys. We have our pro bowler already started walling off his base with houses
Yeah, but
and.
then pro always getting sneaked every time. Look, two archers in my base from the top, three from the bottom. That's why I make scums because I just can't micro in open maps.
Makes
So
sense.
because of that auto fire thing, he lost his tower. If you now look at the tower, almost.
Yeah, there you go, one tower down, and.
Ha, so now that made me feel much safer than before.
And also, you have enough skirms here to defend these archers
Ha.
and
So I think
try to
that was
kill
a
them.
mistake on his part. He should have kept that tower up somehow. That was causing a lot of idle time.
Oh man, you just passed each other and nothing happened here.
Where? Oh yeah. Oh, so I was trying to right click my skirmishers into his stone mine.
But man, this fight is happening all over the map. Fights happening in the middle.
Scums, archers, two, three archers, two, three scums.
Damn it, the fight is everywhere. It's difficult to micro when something like this is going on. It's too difficult.
Yeah, so at this point of time, so scums can kill villagers after many hits. Not that bad at killing villagers.
So, but right now the eco looks pretty bad to you, and Blitz.
Yeah, because now he's put five more archers on my stone. I'm losing wills there, but here I'm pushing. I'm breaking his star with Manitams and scums.
Oh, yeah.
Not scum, madam.
Scums go to prevent repairing. But man, this harassment is really.
But those five archers and my amazing multitasking. Now I realize that there are archers in my base.
Many wheels over there.
Yeah. So now he's four wheels up, and I had a two wheel advantage before. So that is the advantage that archers have over scums.
And also you lost a lot of scums to the TC fire over there.
Yeah, in general, see, if it was arena, I'm used to arena, so we only fight in one place.
Yeah.
So there, scums kill archers. But here, five archers can just raid your entire economy. That's why archers are usually preferred players, I think.
And also they get you to castle pretty fast.
Ha, true. They don't cost food. Mm-hmm. Best thing. But, well, I like scums. Because you don't have to micro, just patrol them and they'll do everything.
Oh, yes. It's true.
So now he has three more archers in my base.
Yeah, those archers are not going out.
One thing he did now is he committed to feudal age, longer feudal age. He could have gone castle directly.
Yeah.
Because he made archers, but he realized that I was going pure scums. So he then made a few scouts.
Yep.
Exactly. So scouts counters comes pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
But luckily I had a few manatoms lying around, so I didn't lose that fight too badly.
Oh yes.
Then I made a few spears as well.
Perfect.
Again, he's again taking five archers into my base.
Those archers are not leaving at all. They just go, like five archers at every single damn time. They're just going to the stone just to make sure that no.
So they're idling both my scums. But this time I kept a few scums there. So now they'll die soon, hopefully. The main problem for me right now was tackling scouts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I could have just gone pure scum and stopped everything, but now scouts.
Now scouts, so now you have to switch
so,
to pike.
I had to mix in a few spears, that's fine. Plus, see, he still has the better unit composition, I think.
He has
map control, he is pushing.
And he clicked up the castle faster than you.
He clicked up to castle as well. But that is because, better eco, archers, over scums.
Yep.
So now I also use the market, sold everything, and I'm trying to get resources. But then I did real battle instead of castle for some reason.
So still your role has not finished it. There's still some open places.
I saw it. He's raiding my eco every time.
Yeah. So usually like when all the games that I have watched from you. So by now like you sort of finish your walling. So this is like some sort of special bonus to Mega Random. So going pretty soon.
Because being an arena player, I'm not that used to doing so much early game.
Oh, yeah.
So that's why I'm put off my game when all these raidings happen.
So all the fight, ladies and gentlemen, it's happening here. At one place.
So now we have archers versus scums.
Mm-hmm. And two villages.
So ideally, you could micro, but then with 400 ping, Blitz should just go back.
Yeah. And with
that he's up first.
I think he should fall back and maybe
exactly once he gets crossbow and bodkin arrow he could fight then.
Mm-hmm. But he doesn't have crossbow upgrade, but yes.
So exactly, but then see scums can't deal much damage. So if he just falls back to his TC right now, I won't be able to do too much.
Oh yeah.
So now he's castle. He'll make crossbows and push me back. And the main thing, so see, crossbows are not that big a deal because I have many scums. The main problem is the one knight that's gonna pop out, yeah.
One knight is more than enough to kill all these scums.
Luckily I had one spear that dropped his health to half. But then knights are a huge problem for scums.
So knight, these at this point, are...
they're a pain.
So what was going in your mind now, right now? Because their knights out.
So right now I just had to get enough spears out. I didn't have wood for a barrack. I was going to get to castle edge, okay? So now I don't feel comfortable with one TC. I at least had one more.
Okay.
So now if you look at my wood, I was calculating. So I had to make one TC. That elite scum research.
Oh, yes.
Lumber research, and then eventually I had to add a siege workshop. Because so many Britain crossbows, I mean mangonels had to be added to save my eco.
That's true.
Plus walling, I have put a very long wall that's, but if you
still,
look.
Still not there, probably it's gonna come up
soon. Look from my perspective, look at it from my perspective.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Them.
Boys, our pro waller is here and he's walling.
Pro waller always has holes in his walls, but okay.
But one hole is fine.
At this point, see, crossbows, again, they aren't that big a problem because I am Celts, I'll make good mangonels, I'll have elite skirmishers. The main problem is knights again.
Yeah.
So stopping knights, I just had to keep spears pumping. So then I decided to go pikeman.
Oh yeah.
So again, the problem is not used to such early attacks. The eco balance is really tough earlier.
Yes. And yeah, especially so it's not towers and get too many skirms.
So now he's pulling ahead in villagers. He already has two TCs, three TCs.
And he's at 52 wills.
Cheaper
and
TCs.
You're at 44.
44, yeah. Cheaper wills. Not cheaper wills, cheaper TCs for him, so more wills. So now we both have mangonels.
So both
mine
both
are better.
Have, yeah, siege workshop and mangonels are being produced. So he's coming forward.
Mine are better, so.
And knights and crossbows.
So he has gone for all gold units and I have gone for all trash. Right now.
Oh, yeah. Trash is, I think, pretty much.
Trash is fun for
especially when it comes to like gold units, like proper counters.
Man,
that mangonel shot was crazy.
Not that bad a shot, I just lost one scum. That's a bad shot for him.
Oh my, he lost half of his crossbows over there.
Just yeah, exactly.
Oh my god.
So at this point of time, I just had to get rid of the knight somehow and I would win this fight. I trade a mangonel for a mangonel.
Oh, both the players losing so much army here to those mangonel shots. Damn, man.
So right now I can take this engagement, but he can't. Because now we've lost everything, it's crossbow versus scum.
And he doesn't have knights.
But again, the same thing, he'll make one knight and he'll kill my entire army. So that's why, and all my spears are now dead.
Oh yes, you have to maintain that. Spear production.
Yeah, so at this point of time, I thought I'll have to make one more barrack. Because one simply wasn't enough to stop continuous knights if you made them. Now see, he's putting up the second stable.
Yes.
So even he realizes that my army could be countered by knights. Master of knights. So I think I'll put up a second barrack soon, that's what I thought. I don't know when I'll put it up, but that should have been the ideal case. Now when things have finally stabilized, I've defended his first push. Now I can get into my comfort zone, the arena style, so I'm putting up more TCs.
And also the wall is almost done, finally.
Yeah, so at least I can be sure that I won't be raided with crossbows.
But knights are coming, and I think you have enough.
Knights are coming, but then I have a TC up top and this area I'll have spears. At this point, I should have microed better, but then with not that easy.
Yeah,
with 400 ping. Yeah, so if it's responsive, both players usually go for a fight. But here, both of us were scared of a fight because, well, lag.
Yep, and you are on PTCs and Blitz is on 3 DCs, so both the
3 DCs as well, but he'll have resources. He'll have more resources.
He has more
plus resources. Look at the build difference.
Will difference is huge.
He has more three. Resources, much more wills. Now he's trying to raid my eco with 5 knights. I think, yeah. They have 2 plus 2, so all this TC fire does not deal a lot of damage.
Can do actually a lot of harassment over there. There you go.
Yeah, exactly. That 2 plus 2 defense.
Our pro walling is still continuing, guys. So
yeah, now I got a good shot over here. 1 for 2 mangonels.
Oh man, I just missed that.
Down at the archery range. Plus I have Celt mangonels, so they fire faster. That's the main benefit for going for Celts here in this age.
Yeah, awesome siege.
Otherwise, Britons are completely. Britons are much stronger than Celts usually.
Look at the thing already, the range.
But yeah, mangonel wars. I can do better in mangonel wars simply because mine fire faster. So.
So 8 range versus 6
range. If I get a lucky
range.
Shot, I can trade 1 for 2, something like that.
The range is
so
insane.
Now, yeah, the range becomes insane soon in this age archer fight. Huh?
So right now you skirms have...
are a hard counter.
You skirms have only like 6 range and his crossbows are at 8 range. And your
exactly.
Mangonels
but my mangonels are 7 range.
He can,
so
if
now,
he has enough crossbows, he can actually snipe them pretty easily.
Not really, it's hard to micro down 5 mangonels and Celt mangonels, they fire faster.
Yeah, 5
maybe
five
as arbalests. Huh, against 5 is difficult, against 1, yeah, surely.
So
but now
castle,
see, I've broken his siege workshop.
Yeah. And the castle is going at the right location. So that gives you like the complete control in the middle, the castle that you are building.
Yeah, plus it saves my eco. So control is one thing. I can play calmly when my eco is safe. That's the main thing. So yeah, that was more important for me. So now this is more in my comfort zone. Comes arena.
Oh yeah. So everything is walled. It's pretty safe and secured.
Yeah. So at this point of time, I knew that my eco was way behind his.
And
so
look at
I
the build
added
difference, 76 wills to 95 wills.
75 to 96, but I added a 4th TC to catch up in that regard.
But the military
plus,
is insane, you have 50 military and he has only 28 military.
True, but mine are trash.
Hey, yours is trash, yeah. They can die anytime, but...
So, again, at this point of time, so looking at this from a battle perspective, he'll get to Imperial Age.
Pretty fast.
And if I fight army versus army, he'll definitely kill mine.
Yes. So you... But these Vogue Raiders,
so,
they're really good.
Not really. So, just against Arbalest, they aren't. But if you look at the stone mine below my castle, you'll know my plan.
But yeah. So probably one more castle coming up soon.
So yeah, at this point of time I realized Britons usually, I mean, see, I didn't think of this at that time, but he does not have any stone. Look at his base.
His base.
Both his stones are forward and my castle is on them.
So he just cannot collect
and
those stones.
And you can't kill 2 castles without a castle of your own.
Yeah. Oh so, my god, that shot was crazy. He lost his 80%.
That was lucky for me since he'll just get Arbalest, so I killed half his army there.
Oh man, that was just a crazy shot. He had to go back, there's no way he could actually come forward and
exactly.
Do like any sort
but
of...
But now, see, because of the 4 TCs, look at the build difference now.
Yeah. Build difference is here pretty same. It's not that much now. It's 88.
Yeah, because 86. Now it's 3 DC versus 4 DC. It's almost 0.
And the eco
plus
is pretty strong for you at the moment.
His gold miners are also pretty idle, whatever. So now I realize that if I make 3 or 4 castles there, I'll buy myself time to reach Imperial Age.
Yep.
Because
right
now
any,
I'm far from
story.
Imperial. Huh?
He doesn't have any other location.
Yeah, even if he had, if I make 5 castles, he'll take time to break them.
Yep.
So that's what I thought at this point of time.
And
because I am far from Imperial Age and he is an Imperial already.
Yeah, and also, like with this, like China walling, it would be difficult for him to break with just.
But okay, so at this point of time, what he could have done. I had castles. He couldn't have won a 1v1 fight directly. He should have just raided my entire eco with Arbalest.
Yes.
My China walls are still palisade.
Yeah, he could actually break down if he wanted to with that.
Easily, yeah.
Plus.
But then it's hard if you have half your eco under two castles, you know.
And also, his eco was constantly getting raided, and he just lost one TC. There's no way he's gonna send all those Arbalasts to your base.
Exactly. It's hard to think about all this while playing the game.
Yep.
After the game, sure you'll realize that I don't have anything to push him properly. So he could have just sent his Arbas, killed half of my eco inside.
Oh yes.
But now I sold all my stone. I realized I have 3 castles. Too much stone.
The 3 castles.
I sold some 700-800 stone and then I bought myself up to Imperial.
There you go, boys. Our second layer of wall is coming up. This time it's
stone wall.
Damn wall.
So, after clicking, I thought about how I would try and win this game. So I had map control and everything. Kels, he's just super powerful. He just has Arbalest. He doesn't have a castle.
Yep.
So if I just make onagers and keep map control and don't let him raid, I'll win this game.
Mm-hmm.
As simple as that. So that is my plan was.
So that's why
I'm reinforcing my walls again.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense then. You need these stone walls just to stop that raiding and stuff. Mm-hmm. Which makes
Plus,
perfect sense.
I am heavy on his stone. I have some 20-30 villagers mining all of his stone. So I'm just putting castles wherever I can.
Oh man, the fourth castle is coming out now. That's just crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like, Britons, like, with that range, if they can get up like 2 or 3 castles and all those traps, it's gonna be insane.
But now, that's the main problem. While fighting a player who's making a lot of castles, not that big a shot, okay. But yeah, all his arbalests are now red.
Yep, they're like very low on hit points. Like one more shot, like half of that army is gone.
Exactly. So, this is one thing Arena teaches you. Is that if you want to counter someone who's making castles, you have to buy a castle. If you don't have stone, you somehow need to make a castle of your own.
Yeah.
Otherwise, there's no point of advancing to Imperial before your opponent.
Yeah. And he just bought some stone and he's building a castle. But man,
yeah, exactly. That's what he's doing now. That's too late because now I am imp.
Yeah. One castle against 4 castles, there's no way it's gonna stand to that.
Exactly, but think of the fact that if he had made a castle 7 to 8 minutes before,
mm-hmm.
he could have trapped down mine.
Yes, yeah, exactly. But he's too late on the castle. Yeah.
Exactly. So a castle is very important when fighting castle.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Narval. Okay. Who is co-casting? TK, welcome back, man. I hope you had a great holiday. Co-caster is Askikara. So we are just casting his game today. RRTS 2 Sultans Battle, and this is the first game between Aski and Blitz. So right now Blitz is in bad position. He is getting constantly raided in all the directions and he's gonna lose that castle too. And look at the will difference now. 120 wills to 111. And that army is not bad, but he just has those Arbalasts. He doesn't have anything else now.
But yeah, so see, in an ideal scenario, Britain Arbalest can micro down managers. But with 600 ping, it's not that case. Yeah, with 600 ping, if I just have one onager shooting and I just patrol all my ward raiders into his Arbalest, I'll win.
Makes sense.
So, if you look at the bottom, I patrolled all my ward raiders into his base.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah, they're doing a lot of raiding.
He's losing wills. And yeah, some Vogueres are attacking the
military. So I didn't micro at all, so I just patrolled them, so half of them are breaking blacksmith, his siege workshops and stuff.
So this is how you win the games, when there is a lag. Just
true. When there's lag, you can't rely on micro.
Yes, yeah, that's true.
Plus, it's a real-time strategy game. If you just get your units, right? I don't think micro should be that big a reason in choosing your unit. Ideally.
There you go, Blitz just called GG.
Well played. A little ahead.
Well played, Aske, over there. And congratulations for the first win. So now Blitz chooses the map, right? So loser picks.
Yeah, so it was game one loser's home map. Mm-hmm. So he now it's time for his home
map. TK and Narwhal is they're saying like who cast their own game? We do guys. So this is the fun part of ROTS2. So everything is for fun. So let's have a quick look at the achievements. So 122 wills to Ash over there and 115 wills to Blitz. And the feudal castle. Who, Narwhal?
Yeah.
Man, if you would have lost the game, then you had a reason to say like you lost it because of Narwhal.
True.
Waller? No, man, he's not a Waller. He's pro Waller. And. Anyway,
you'll change that notion after 20 minutes, I assure you. Let's go to the next game.
Okay.
The notion that I'm a pro baller.
Achievements. So, Indus reached to all the ages pretty faster than Aske, but still, he just could not get that map control.
That's the turning point in this game. He was ahead of me till 50 minutes. If you look at the Imperial Age timing. But if he just had one castle, just imagine, if he just had one castle, he could have trapped down mine and he had 7 minutes of time.
Yep.
Then if you look at the map explored, we have Mem's favorite number, both of us.
It's true. Oops.
Then I think that's all that you need to look here.
What's the prize pool of the tourney? We'll just put their names on the websites. That's the prize pool.
Largest army is also same.
Yeah, army wise and like everything is almost the same. It's just the map control and also what do you call that, like right counters,
I guess. That one thing was in my favor. I got a few good mangonel shots in Castle Age on his archers.
Oh yeah, those mangonels.
Otherwise,
those few shots,
if he had some 40-50 arbalists in Imperial, he would have killed everything easily.
Oh yes, and the second game is Arabia.
His home map,
His home map, loser home map picked by Blitz. So this is Arabia, guys. Second map. So let's see. Let's get into the game.